In part one of our lesson on graphs of secant and cosecant, we will create the graph of secant. A quick reminder that a rational function written in the form of n of x over d of x will have vertical asymptotes when n of x, the numerator, does not equal zero at the places where d of x, the denominator, does equal zero. We know that secant of x is equal to 1 over the cosine of x. So that will have vertical asymptotes when 1 over cosine of x, when cosine of x in the denominator is equal to 0. Because clearly we can see that the numerator here never equals 0. So whenever cosine has a root, we know we're going to satisfy this condition because the numerator is never 0. Now when we look at the graph of cosine, we see that it has roots at negative 3 pi over 2, negative pi over 2, positive pi over 2, and positive 3 pi over 2. So those will translate into the vertical asymptotes for secant. We see then our asymptotes will be at negative 3 pi over 2, next at negative pi over 2, positive pi over 2, and at 3 pi over 2. We can plot a few points for secant, so let's get a chart of values going over here. When x is 0, we know that secant, being 1 over the cosine, you probably know the cosine of 0 is 1, so 1 over 1 is equal to 1. So we know the secant of 0 is 1. Now let's think about how this will approach the asymptotes. You can see that as the x value of cosine approaches pi over 2, its y value is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So as cosine of x gets smaller and smaller, 1 over cosine of x will get bigger and bigger. So as the y value of cosine approaches 0, the y value of secant then is going to approach infinity. And same going towards this asymptote over here. As the y value of cosine goes to 0, since that's the denominator of a fraction, as the denominator of a fraction goes to 0, the fraction goes to infinity. If we look at the secant of pi now, we know that the cosine of pi is negative 1. 1 over negative 1 is negative 1. So the secant of pi, we can plot that point, y value is negative 1. And we can use the same kind of argument here. As the y value of cosine goes towards 0, this time it's through negative numbers. If the denominator is negative, the whole fraction is negative. So as the denominator goes to 0 through negative numbers, the fraction will go to negative infinity. And the same thing will happen as the graph of cosine goes towards 3 pi over 2. The y values are going towards 0, but again, through negative numbers. So then that means the y values of secant will go to negative infinity. If we plug in 2 pi, 2 pi is coterminal with 0, so we know the value of the secant will be 1. And we can use that same analysis. As the y value of cosine approaches 0, the y value of secant will approach infinity. Over on the negative side of the graph, if we plug in negative pi, we know negative pi is coterminal with pi on the unit circle, so the secant is going to be negative 1. When we look at the graph of cosine, its y values are going towards 0 as the x values go towards negative pi over 2 on this piece of the graph. As the y values of cosine go to 0, we know the y values of secant will go to infinity, and again, since it's through negative numbers, secant will have to go to negative infinity. Same thing here, as x approaches negative 3 pi over 2 on the cosine graph, its y values are going to 0, but going through negative numbers, so then that means secant's y values are going towards negative infinity. If we plug in x equals negative 2 pi, we know that negative 2 pi on the unit circle is coterminal with 0, so we expect the y value here to be a 1. And as the y values of cosine get small, the y values of secant get big. So there's our graph of y equals secant of x. Now let's do some analysis of this graph. We see this graph definitely does repeat itself, and if we use a cycle for an asymptote all the way to an asymptote, we can look at this being the start of a period and this being the end. Now this can't be the end because that would only have this chunk of the graph then. We need a chunk of the graph doing the positive y values, and to complete the period we need a chunk of the graph doing the negative y values. So if we start at negative pi over 2 and go all the way to 3 pi over 2, then we can subtract to find the period. 3 pi over 2 minus negative pi over 2 is equal to 4 pi over 2, which is 2 pi. So the period of secant is 2 pi. When looking at the domain, we see there are definitely x values we have to exclude. Negative 3 pi over 2, negative pi over 2, positive pi over 2, positive 3 pi over 2. There are going to be infinitely many places where we have to exclude the x values. We notice that the distance between those x values is pi. From pi over 2 to 3 pi over 2 is pi. From pi over 2 to negative pi over 2 is pi. From pi over 2 to negative 3 pi over 2 is 2 pi. So these are going to be integer values of pi away from each other. So we know how to say that x cannot equal, we give a starting value of pi over 2, and then plus n pi. Remember, n stands for an integer. The range of the graph, well, it goes forever in the negative infinity direction, but it only goes up to negative 1 for this piece. So we have to say from negative infinity until negative 1 union, because then from negative 1 it jumps up to positive 1 and then goes on up to positive infinity. So union 1 to positive infinity. Now the formula for the vertical asymptotes, we've done this before, so we know that we can use the domain because everywhere the x values cannot exist in the domain is because there is a vertical asymptote at that location. So the formula for the vertical asymptotes is that x is going to equal pi over 2 plus n pi. The normal cycle for secant, it's customary to always go asymptote to asymptote for a function, and you pick the cycle that's closest to the origin. So in this case, we would pick this cycle that starts at negative pi over 2 and goes up to 3 pi over 2. That's just the industry standard. We could have picked any cycle, but that's what's customary to use. Now, in that cycle, we notice there are 1, 2, 3 vertical asymptotes. So let's go back to our formula for the vertical asymptotes and figure out what values of n we're going to need to use to get those asymptotes. In our one cycle, we know that the first asymptote is here at negative pi over 2. Well, to get this formula to equal negative pi over 2, we need n to be negative 1. So that pi over 2 minus pi is negative pi over 2. To get the second asymptote, which occurs at pi over 2, we see that we need n to be 0. And to get the third asymptote, which occurs at 3 pi over 2, we need n to equal 1. So here then will be the one normal cycle for secant. Starting at negative pi over 2, because there's the first asymptote, and ending at 3 pi over 2. So notice in this cycle, the five key values starts with a vertical asymptote, then we have this point, which is a minimum, then we have a vertical asymptote, then a point, which is a maximum, and then the vertical asymptote to end it. So 3 of your 5 key values are going to be vertical asymptotes. And here's our graph of y equals secant of x.